Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Chris Badger. Thomas, Right Wing Tribune, London. Senior Iranian officials and military commanders on Tuesday rejected US President Donald Trump's offer of talks without preconditions as worthless and a dream, saying his words contradicted his action of reimposing sanctions on Tehran, Reuters reports. Separately, Iranian President Hassan Rouhani said Trump's repudiation of an international nuclear deal reached in 2015 was illegal, and Iran would not easily yield to Washington's renewed campaign to strangle Iran's vital oil exports. US can only blame itself for pulling out and leaving the table. Threats, sanctions and PR stunts won't work. Trump's offer to negotiate with Tehran contradicted his actions as Washington has imposed sanctions on Iran and put pressure on other countries to avoid business with the Islamic Republic. Mr. Trump, Iran is not North Korea to accept your offer for a meeting. Even US presidents after you will not see that day. Tilde Mohammad Javad Zarif, Iran Foreign Ministry. General Jafari said that the Iranian nation will resist until it achieves final victory and inflicts ultimate defeat on the arrogant powers by withstanding the cruel and inhumane sanctions thanks to the divine promises, huge internal resources and the leadership of a wise leader. Mr. Trump, Iran is not North Korea to give a positive response to your demand for a meeting. You should know that the Iranian nation will never allow their officials to negotiate and meet with the great Satan. The former U.S. presidents who were either military men or politicians knew much better than you were. They learned that Iran and the Iranian people cannot be threatened and rather grow united and single-hearted against any threat and pressure by foreigners. You will take this wish to the grave to see the day when the Islamic Republic of Iran demands for a meeting with you or is allowed by the nation to meet you. You will never see that day. Tilde, commander of the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps, IRGC, Major General Muhammad Ali Jafari. The sanctions reinstated on Iran on May 8 included boycott of Iran's crude supplies and bans on transfer of its crude revenues. There is a 180-day interval before these sanctions come into effect. Other U.S. secondary sanctions are reinstated this month. Iran's currency plumbed new depths on Monday, dropping past 120,000 rials to the dollar, but Trump's expressed willingness to negotiate with Tehran sparked a minor recovery on Tuesday to 110,000 rials on the unofficial market. Videos on social media showed hundreds of people rallying in Isfahan in central Iran, and Karaj near Tehran, in protest at high prices caused in part by the rial's devaluation under heightened U.S. pressure. After Trump's declaration, the Iranian government issued a statement, calling the U.S. withdrawal as unlawful. The statement underlined Iran's prerequisites for continuing the deal with the five world powers. These conditions that were reiterated later by Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Sayed Ali Khamenei later mainly included Iran's guaranteed crude sales and transfer of its revenues back home. 2 months later, the other five powers party to the nuclear deal have failed to satisfy Iran. President Hassan Rouhani voiced his disappointment over a recent package of incentives proposed by the European Union countries to Tehran, and said that the Islamic Republic expected a much better, clearer and explicit stance by the EU, Fars News Agency reported. Chris Badger. Thomas is a veteran who served our country as an army combat medic. God bless. Dean James III, percent Right Wing Tribune. Be sure to follow us on Nation in Distress and America's Freedom Fighters on Facebook.